Hello, hello, hello. It is indeed JEP time. Who'd think that after 7 weeks we would still be doing this? I personally did not. But hey, we're still here. We're ready to answer some questions. I think that's better, huh? Hey, guess what? We back again, indeed, Aiden, my resident clipper. Hey, guys, here's a clue. Check this out. The category is bodies of water. Here's what we're dealing with. This sea that extends about 1,200 miles was referred to in ancient times as the Erythraean Sea. If you guys know it, put it in chat. Div! No, that's wrong, Jack. Try again. What is ice seafood I eat? Ape Minky.
We're going to have a little chat. I think you've been hanging out with Lee too much.
No, the answer was the Red Sea. The answer was the Red Sea, guys. This is not a rerun. I have to change the name of the stream. But I hope you guys are doing very well on this Tuesday night, July 13th. We got some interesting things to talk about before we even begin the game, once we come on camera tonight. Show a copy of today's newspaper. This is what is sea dreams are made of. Oh boy, we're getting, it's not even 9:03 and we're already dealing with the puns. Okay, take a deep breath. You'll be fine. I would put on the song, but I'm afraid we would get DMCA'd right away. Travel the world to the Seven Seas, comedy fan? Alrighty, yeah, I prefer not to get DMCA. Alright, here's another clue, guys. International organizations, best of luck. If you know the answer, put it in chat. Neutrality and voluntary service are two of the seven fundamental principles of this humanitarian organization founded in Europe. If you know the answer, put it in chat. We are coming up on a minute before we say hello to all of you and our players for today. Ooh, good guess, Jack, but no. Well, this was an easy one. It's the Red Cross. The Red Cross was the right answer. Where are your keys? I don't know. I don't know. Where are your keys? Guys, we have 30 seconds. I hope you guys are going to have a fun time. I know I am, and I know our three players are going to have fun. What is Aleppo? Oh, boy. Calm down, take a drink. We're coming on in just a few moments. 10 seconds, here comes the countdown. Let's go! A software engineer from Mountain View, California, Curtis Gray. A local government civil servant from Berkshire, United Kingdom, Jack Karimi. And our returning champion, a sports writer from Cedar City, Utah, Tom Zalewski, whose one-day cash winnings total $25,500. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy! And, well, who do you expect? It's me. Hi, everybody. Welcome to JEP Squad. Thank you all for coming for episode number 7. We got an amazing champion, and we've also got two exciting challengers who are willing to take him on. And before we get into the game, I want to announce a couple of things that definitely pertain to this stream. Tuesday, we won't have a stream. We are going to be moving that to Thursday, which is July 22nd. There are some things going on the 20th that will not allow me to be here on the 20th. So Thursday, July 20th will be episode number 8. So hopefully you guys will be here for that. Also, in August, we are introducing a brand new game element that I will tell you when we come back from our first break. I think you all are going to be excited about it. If you already are a part of our Discord server, you already know what it is. But for our people, for the people watching the stream that are not part of our Discord server, why aren't you, by the way? We'll tell you about that once we get out of break. Tom, Jack, Curtis, you guys are ready to play. I think we're ready to go, huh? Right?
Cool.
Yeah.
Let's go! All right, let's take a look at our categories for tonight, and they are food, fast, and slow. Next, we have also a chess piece. We're going to visit Disneyland. Take a look at today's horoscope. Flag them down. And finally, automobiles. Notice the A in quotation marks. All right, Tom, since you are the champion, you get to start.
Automobiles, 600.
Chrysler and Dodge both made models with the name of this mountainous city. Already our first dud. What is Aspen? Aspen, Colorado. All right, Tom, go again.
Automobiles, 800.
In Goldfinger, James Bond drove a Silver Birch DB5 from this maker. Jack.
What is Aston Martin?
Right, you're on the board.
Also a chess piece, 8.
Oh, look what you found already. Well, you have 800, but you can risk up to $1,000.
Sound effect. 1,000, please.
1,000. All right, here it is. Here's your clue. A Eurasian member of the crow family.
What is a rook?
A rook is right, and you have $1,800. All right, select again.
Chess piece 6.
And the answer is historical books in the Old Testament, both 1 and 2. Jack.
What is Kings?
Kings is right. Go again.
Chess piece 4.
Sir Galahad. Curtis.
What is a knight?
A knight is right.
Chess piece for 2.
To leave something as a guarantee in return for money. Jack.
What is pawn?
Pawn, right.
Finish category.
All right. Desmond Tutu. Tom.
Bishop.
Bishop is right.
Back to automobiles, 400.
Yes. The four-letter name of this German manufacturer is Latin for listen. Tom.
What's Audi?
Audi is right. Now, Aiden, you want to point out something? Put it in chat. What are you pointing out? I'm curious to see what Aiden wants to say.
He didn't play the game.
Yeah, he did have he did have 800, but we go up to 1,000. Okay, Tom, go again.
Automobiles, 1,000.
Ah, the answer is, it's one of Lincoln's luxury SUVs. Tom.
What's the Aviator?
The Aviator is right. Now you are just $200 shy.
Finish automobiles, 200.
It's accurate to say this is Honda's premium brand of cars and SUVs. Tom.
It's Acura.
Acura is right.
Food, fast and slow, 400.
This pudgy turkey company's website says a stuffed 25-pound bird can take more than 6 hours to cook. Curtis.
What is Butterball?
Butterball is right.
Food for 600.
As a noun, it's a burger garnish. As a verb, it's to preserve, say, a cucumber through a long, briny process. Jack.
What is pickle?
Pickle, right.
Flag 'em down, 6.
This anthemic nickname of the U.S. flag was coined by Francis Scott Key. Tom.
It's the Star-Spangled Banner.
Indeed.
Flag, 800.
All right, take a look at the clue. The flag of the U.S. possession seen here is almost the same as the flag of Cuba, but with the colors of red and blue reversed. Jack.
What is Puerto Rico?
Right.
Flag them down 1,000.
Answer is. The fiest. The first 50 U.S. star flag was officially raised on July 4th of this year. Tom.
It's 1960.
1960. Hawaii was established as the 50th state in 1959. Well, look at this. A very interesting start to our game. Jack is putting up a fight against Tom, but Curtis, maybe you'll catch up once we take a quick commercial break. Guys, just take a breather. We'll be right back after these words.
Emotes say a lot, but they can't say it all. Think your guildmate is struggling? Try these dialogue options. Go beyond emotes. Check in with your guildmates at seizetheawkward.org.
Oh, well, thank you. Our children and families want us to be healthy. That's why I and lots of other grown-ups got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we can stay healthy and get back to the moments we miss, like seeing our friends and family.
Here you go, Daddy, for a healthy checkup, a sticker.
Oh, thanks, son.
With free COVID-19 vaccines, sunnier days are ahead. Visit getvaccineanswers.org.
Every day,
millions of people are connecting.
Father. Cosplayer.
Mentor. Actor.
It's time we take a step forward, come together,
and discover
how accepting our differences
can make us stronger.
If you would like to become a contestant for JEP Squad, follow us on Twitter at The JEP Squad. Also, check out our Discord server, where both links will have contestant applications. We can't wait to see you.
All right, everybody, we are back. So let's meet our players for tonight. Curtis Gray, a software engineer, Mountain View, California. So it says here that you were once described as a young superstar by another superstar.
Yeah, when I was a teenager, I worked as a lifeguard at a local water park, and I had sun-bleached hair and everything, but Shaquille O'Neal, the basketball star, came to visit the park one day and stayed after to say hi to everybody, and he told me that I looked like a young Justin Timberlake.
Wow.
I don't know where he saw it, but I'll take the compliment.
Hey, at least it wasn't like, hey, stupid lifeguard, come on down, whatever. Now, I had somewhat of a similar experience myself, actually last year. Now, the guy who did it wasn't as big as, yeah, clip that, Aiden, please. you may want to clip this, too. I was visiting Citi Field for this fan fest for the Mets, and former pitcher, Mets pitcher, Turk Wendell, screamed out of the top of his lungs, "Oh my God, Jonah Hill's in the building!" I want to ask this,
oh,
people.
No.
Do you see Jonah Hill in my damn face?
Oh God, no!
But you know what? This isn't the first time that this has happened. This isn't the first time that I've been, it's probably about like the 20th time I've been called Jonah Hill. Maybe if you let your beard, but I can't grow a beard. I grow fuzz. That's the best I can do, Brian. All right, Curtis, best of luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, Jack Karimi, Berkshire United Kingdom, a local government civil servant. Now, we got a lot of oohs in the chat about that. What exactly do you do?
So, elected councillors in the council have meetings. I put together those meetings, I take the minutes, I make sure that people have access to their local democracy. It's a very strange job, but I feel very sort of honoured to have it.
Oh, man.
At the moment, especially with the pandemic.
Yeah, so have you been able to make eye contact with Prime Minister Boris Johnson?
Or no, is that a... No, it's all online at the moment, which
Okay.
Very strange.
Okay, that makes sense. Now, you are our second United Kingdom competitor, so you're making some history. Now, it says that you visited every museum and art gallery. Now, where exactly did you see those museums?
I took a weekend away, and I went to every museum and art gallery in Liverpool. And I since did over the course of the summer Manchester, and I've done most of the museums and art galleries in London, but there's still ones like there's like a product packaging and advertising museum which I haven't gone to, and a few others like that.
Maybe sometime later in the summer you'll be able to tackle that. All right, Jack, best of luck to you. All right, Tom, our champion, one day, 25,500. So, apparently, one time during an interview, somebody had your back, and I'm curious to find out who this was.
This was way in the Wayback Machine of sorts. I was covering the San Francisco 49ers for a smaller suburban paper in the San Francisco area. Attended a game, the Atlanta Falcons, back in at the turn of the millennium. Couldn't beat the 49ers to save their lives, basically, no matter how hard they tried. And I was able to corral Steve Mariucci one-on-one. He was the head coach then. And we're going over things and trying, and he's giving me the spiel about why they've been so good, a lot of luck, some good play calling and so forth. And then a Hall of Fame NFL writer, I won't drop names here, marches right in. With Mariucci one-on-one, marches right in, starts talking to someone else. He's talking about something else. Mariucci looks at him with that teacher's look that knows the kid caught his hand in the cookie jar and says, "Do you mind?" I'm like, hey, after he walked away, we finished the interview and bam, it was done. And I gave it the chest thump and said, "Yes, please. I'm awesome today."
That's awesome, dude. You know, it's definitely not like Lou Piniella, because Lou Piniella, I don't think, liked the media.
Nope.
No, he did not. Speaking of Tom, you have control. You have control of the round, and you may continue.
The food fast and slow, 200, please.
Quaker sells apple and cinnamon flavored instant this. Curtis.
What is oatmeal?
Yes.
Food for eight.
Created by Paul and David Mirage in 1983, these meat and cheese sandwiches are ready after 2 minutes in the microwave. Tom.
For Hot Pockets.
Hot Pockets. I had to do that.
Fish food for 1,000.
Cooked for hours, Boston baked beans are traditionally made from these beans, named for their color. Tom.
What are navy beans?
No.
Ooh.
And that are white beans.
White.
Ooh. Mm.
Tom, go again.
Disneyland, 400.
Let's go meet Mickey Mouse, shall we? This attraction celebrated 50 years of retirement unliving in 2019. Curtis.
What is the Haunted Mansion?
Yes.
Disneyland for six.
This Tomorrowland crawler closed in 1995, but the tracks still remain. Jack.
What is the monorail?
No. Curtis.
What is the People Mover?
The People Mover is right.
800 Disney.
General admission for adults costs $1 when the park first opened its doors in this mid-decade year. Tom.
It's 1955?
Correct.
Disneyland, 1,000.
Answer is, tucked away in New Orleans Square, this members-only restaurant has the park's most exclusive dining. Jack.
What is Club 88?
No. Curtis.
What is Club 33?
Club 33, yes.
Disney for two.
Answer is, a Frontierland, Adventureland, or Pioneerland, the one you won't find on the current park map. Curtis.
What is Pioneerland?
And you have control. Again.
let's go back to flags for four.
The national flags of the United States, Mexico, and Canada all include these two colors. Tom.
What are red and white?
Right.
Finnish flags, 200.
All right, take a look. The Alamo is located in this city and is depicted on the flag seen here. Tom.
What is San Antonio?
Right.
Hi, Lindsay Gelder, past Jeopardy player who lives out that, that part of the world. A day's horoscope, 400.
April 20th to May 20th. Quick decisions are necessary. Be bullish. Jack.
What is Taurus?
Taurus, right.
Horoscope 6.
February 19th to March 20th. Something's fishy. And it's this mutable water sign. I can't read today. Curtis.
What is Pisces?
Pisces is right. Clip that, please.
800.
June 21st to July 22nd. Why so crabby? Curtis.
What is cancer?
Cancer is right.
1,000.
Answer is, for those born between January 20th and February 18th, it's the age of this air sign. Curtis.
What is Aquarius?
Yes, and the last clue. For those born between July 23rd and August 22nd, this fire sign is ready to roar. Jack.
What is Leo?
Leo is right. That takes you up to 3,000. Curtis has a $200 lead at 5,600 and 5,400 for Tom. So, Jack, you are going to go first in Double Jeopardy. But when we come back, anything can happen. So, please, stick around.
Prescription drug pricing points to corporate mountain.
Freedom of the press is about your right to know. It's about your right to be informed. Today, there are real threats to press freedom.
He's reaching residential areas.
And your right to know about the world around us. We must protect our right to know, no matter what kind of news is important to you. Before it's too late, understand the threats. ProtectPressFreedom.org.
As they head toward the finish, Warren has built a substantial lead and headed for her fourth gold medal.
She's ahead of the world record pace by at least half a second, and she... Oh, wait, what's she doing?
I think she's doing a headstand. Why would she do that?
She's stopping. She stopped.
I've never seen
she was so close
like
to
this.
The finish, and she stopped. I don't know what she's thinking. This is unbelievable. Yeah, I've never...
The COVID-19 vaccines can be our chance to get back to our plans, who we are, what we miss, to get back to each other, to life. But it's okay to have questions, like, how were the vaccines tested? In rigorous clinical trials among adults of diverse backgrounds, can the vaccines give you COVID-19? You cannot get COVID-19 from a vaccine. Why should I get vaccinated? Protecting yourself also helps protect the people around you. Find the latest information at getvaccineanswers.org.
Every day,
millions of people are connecting.
Father.
Cosplayer.
Mentor.
Actor.
It's time we take a step forward, come together,
and discover
how accepting our differences
can make us stronger.
Welcome back, everybody. While we were on break, we were talking about Disney because that's Curtis's strongest category. And we were talking about, if you guys remember the show House of Mouse, that was 20 years ago or something? The guy who voiced the microphone, who introduced Mickey at the beginning of the show, you learned today, Curtis, that it was Rod Roddy. Yep. You did not know it was Rod Roddy?
I did not know that, but yeah. today I learned.
Well, you learn something new every day. What? Catherine's going, shame, shame, shame.
I thought it was somebody doing a Rod Roddy impression, so no, I didn't know it was actually him.
It was really him. Cappers, be nice. All right, guys, we're getting ready for Double Jeopardy, and here are the categories for Double Jeopardy. They are A Dose of Medicine. Next, we're going to look at paintings, very appropriate for Jack. Quote, unquote. Then we're going to do some drama club tryouts. How many years? And finally, let's have some fun. F-U-N, in quotation marks, you know that as always. All right, Jack, we're going to start with you. You have control.
How many years for 800?
Tricentennial. Jack.
What is 300?
Right.
Year 12.
Biennial. Jack.
What is two?
Two, yes, two.
Year 16.
Quincentennial. Tom.
500.
500 is right.
How many years? 2000.
Sesquicentennial, whatever. Tom.
It's 150, and that's sesquicentennial.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, cameras, I choked.
All right. Sorry, man. I've heard it before. Finish years for four.
Millennium. Jack.
What is 1,000?
1,000 is right.
Quote, unquote, four.
In Poor Richard's Almanac, this man wrote, "He that lies down with dogs shall rise up with fleas." Tom.
It was Ben Franklin.
Yes.
Quote, unquote, 800.
Investing advice from this Berkshire Hathaway CEO: when it's raining gold, reach for a bucket, not a thimble. Jack.
It was Warren Buffett.
Yes.
Quote, unquote, 12.
In 1954, this Wisconsin senator who saw red was asked by Joseph Welch, "Have you no sense of decency?" Jack.
Who's McCarthy?
Right.
Quote, unquote, 16.
At her wedding, this star of Trainwreck took to the mic and said, "I just wanted to plug some of my road dates." Curtis.
Who is Amy Schumer?
Right.
Finish the category.
In 2019, this Little Women actress said she was happy as a single woman, calling it being self-partnered. Jack.
Who is Emma Watson?
Right.
Medicine 4.
Can you repeat that again?
Oh, sorry. Medicine 4.
Medicine for 4. Look what you did. You found one of the Daily Doubles.
Okay.
All right. You have 9,400. You are tied for first place now. Before you make your your wager, chat, how much do you think Jack should wager? Capris is saying full send.
But I'll do 3,400.
3,400, not a problem. Here is your clue. Antacids can usually ease the symptoms of gastritis, an inflammation of the lining of this organ.
What is the stomach?
And that is right. You now have 12,800. You are in the lead. You may select again.
Should have gone all in. Medicine 8.
From the Greek for against life, these substances kill or inhibit the growth of infectious organisms. Jack.
What is antibacterial?
No. Curtis.
What are antibiotics?
Right, antibiotics. Curtis, go again.
Let's have some fun for four.
Answer is, this type of rotating cone-like cloud isn't called a tornado until it touches the ground. Curtis.
What is a funnel cloud?
Funnel, right.
800, fun.
The name of a literary organization says reading is this. Curtis.
What is fundamental?
Right.
1200, fun.
It's the last name of Adam Wagnall's partner in the dictionary game. Tom.
It's funk.
Funk, right. You know, Braden made me laugh. Okay, go again.
Drama club tryouts, 400.
Answer is, be our guests and come audition for the lead role of Belle in this musical. Tom.
Beauty and the Beast.
Be our guest, be our guest. Go again.
Drama club, 800.
Win the role of Elphaba in this musical and your friends will be green with envy. Jack.
What is Wicked?
Yes, and I'm seeing them the second day they open up on Broadway. Okay, go again.
Medicine 12.
Answer is, Advil is a trade name for this pain reliever often taken instead of aspirin. Jack.
What is paracetamol?
No. Curtis.
What is ibuprofen?
Ibuprofen, correct.
Fun for 16.
Architect Louis Sullivan said that form follows this. Tom.
What's function?
Function, correct.
Finish, fun, 2000.
It's a cable railway that goes up a mountain. And that would be a funicular. I choked three times. Yes, Dev, these scores. Oh my goodness. Okay, Tom, go again.
Drama club, 1200.
Answer is, it's Salem, 1692, and we're having a witch hunt to cast John and Elizabeth Proctor in this Arthur Miller play. Jack.
What is The Crucible?
Correct.
Drama club, 16.
And you found the other one.
Oh, no.
You are up, you are up by $200. Chat, what do you think you should do?
Oh, brother.
I think I've reached the end of my theater knowledge. 2800.
2800, not a problem. Here's your clue. Don't bother auditioning to play the title character in this 1952 Beckett play. He is a no-show.
No, I'm going to kick myself.
No.
Can't think of it.
Oh, sorry. What is Waiting for Godot? But that's totally fine. You still are in the mix. You still have 10,000. It's still your turn.
Finish the category.
Looking for overachievers to play Chip, Schwarzy, Coney Bear, and Barfy in the 25th annual Putnam County this. Tom.
It's the spelling bee.
Correct.
Medicine, 16.
It's the nighttime, sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head, fever, so you can rest, medicine. Curtis.
What is NyQuil?
Correct.
Finished medicine.
He worked on an anti-flu vaccine in the 1940s, which led him to an inactivated polio vaccine in 1952. Tom.
Who is... Fleming?
No. Jack.
Is Lister?
No. Curtis?
Nope.
Who is Jonas Salk? Jonas Salk. All right, we've got one category left. Curtis, it's still your turn.
400 paintings.
In Grant Wood's American Gothic, a farmer is holding this in his right hand. Jack.
What is a pitchfork?
Correct.
Painting day.
A view from an asylum window in southern France inspired his 1889 work, The Starry Night. Jack.
Who is Vincent? Van Gogh.
Right.
Painting still.
Picasso painted the three musicians in this real square style. Jack.
What is cubism?
Right.
Painting 16.
Appropriately, Da Vinci painted this masterpiece on the wall of a dining hall in Italy. Jack.
What is the Last Supper?
Right, and the last clue for 2000. Rembrandt depicted this man contemplating the bust of Homer. And that would be Aristotle. Look at these scores, ladies and gentlemen. A $600 difference for each of them. Tom, you have a $600 lead. Jack and Curtis, you both have $12,000. This is probably our closest game of JEP Squad as of yet. I've never seen this, guys. This is going to be a very interesting Final Jeopardy as we take a look at the category, and it is Superfoods. All right, players, make your wagers when we come back. Oh, boy, this could be anybody's game. You don't want to miss this.
If I could be you, and you could be me for just 1 hour. If we could find a way to get inside each other's minds. If you could see you through my eyes instead of your ego. I believe you'd be surprised to see that you've been blind. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Yeah, before you abuse, criticize and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes. Walk a mile in my shoes. Well, before you abuse, criticize and accuse. Walk a mile in my shoes.
This is a very close game, and I believe the nerves are very present in this room right now. But guys, you've had some time to figure out what you wanted to do as far as a wager goes, and I'm happy to reveal the clue to you. Best of luck. Here it is. This fruit, Fragaria and Ananassa, isn't really a berry. It also isn't the only fruit with seeds on the outside. You have 30 seconds to make your response. And also, I want to point this out. You don't have to hit enter or anything. The game will automatically take your answer. And you also have to phrase in the form of a question, like always. 30 seconds. Good luck. All right, guys. Nope, nope, turn off. You turn off music. All right, let's take a look at your responses. We're going to go to Jack first. You were technically in third place with Cappers, what did I do? All right, let's take a look at Jack's response. You came up with, what is a strawberry? And that is the correct response. And let's see how much you're going to add to your 12,601. That'll take you up to 12,601. You are in first place at the moment. Curtis, let's see what you put down. You also put down what is a strawberry. And how much did you add? Nothing. Oh, boy. Jack, you may have a chance if Tom did not get this one right. Here is Tom's response. Oh, my gosh. What is acai? How much is this going to cost Tom? 12,000. That's going to bring him down to 600. Jack, you are the new JEP Squad champion. You're coming back next week. What an upset, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, my God. Jack, congratulations. Tom, you had an incredible run. We'll see you back here very soon, and I'm very certain of it. And guys, I can't talk as I'm in shock right now. Tom, let's give Tom a round of applause for being such an amazing champion. Curtis, you too, you did it. This was the best game we've ever done. I mean, the five-day champion was one thing, but Jack, you pulled it out of thin air with that last category. You were in third place. My goodness, what a game. Jack, we'll see you next week with two other new players. My name is Hirsch, and I need some alcohol. Good night. Guys, also remember, if you haven't done so already, check us out on our Discord server because we're always looking for new contestants, and we're also looking for new people who want to be part of the team. Writers, moderators, anything. Guys, this was so awesome. I can't wait for you to see this over and over again. We'll see you guys on Thursday, July 22nd, for our next show. Good night, everybody!